The world is out to get you. You are constantly surrounded by viruses and fungi and bacteria and protistins and even worms that would just love to set up shop in your warm, yummy body. And in fact, it's not until you look at the medical histories of people who have immune deficiency diseases that you realize what a series of horrible fates you constantly and unconsciously defend yourself against. And that's what this course is all about. Measles? I've had measles, not getting that one again. Immunology can be a tough course. It has an annoyingly specialized terminology, a vast array of different components, and every single component affects the performance of every other. And so the whole system is so complex, we're dividing it into two parts. In part two, we will cover cellular immunity. We will focus on how T cells recognize antigen on MHC and then produce cytokines with which they will upregulate the entire immune response. Happily, I run my courses by the philosophy of the great ballerina Dame Margot Fontaine, who observed, "The one important thing I've learned in this world is the difference between taking one's work seriously and oneself seriously. The first is imperative and the second disastrous." So while this is a serious course, I am not a serious person. Cholera? In the water supply? Oh no! There is almost nothing I wouldn't do to make this course more engaging and comprehensible, including building models, using military metaphors, engaging in role-play games, and designing animations. Now, it would help if you remember some high school chemistry and you remember enough of introductory biology to know something about protein or cell structure, but I have review materials available in case that's not you. So I hope you will join me. Whether you're taking an immunology course or teaching an immunology course, or have a family member with medical issues you want to understand, or if you just want a really solid background in immunology, I hope that this course will provide you the resources that you need.